Over the last 100 years, women have made great advancements in our education, our careers, and we are more empowered than ever to choose who we date and how. Here's a look at how dating has evolved over the last 100 years. We'll begin in the 1920s because, let's face it, before then, it was pretty much a blur of arranged marriages. What a drag. Higher demand for mass production of the automobile in the 20s gave way to a new kind of freedom. Singles could meet outside the household in social settings. It was a magical time because dating finally became, well, fun. The cultural shift in the 1930s turned courtship into a popularity game. The more men that asked you out, the more popular you were. And the more popular you were, the more men asked you out. It wasn't uncommon to have two or three dates in a single day. This was the case until a small itty-bitty problem disrupted the more the merrier mentality when it came to dating. World War II. Okay, fine. It was a big problem. Young men were drafted to fight in the war in large numbers, causing a huge shortage of eligible bachelors. Once the war ended in 1945, men came home and marriage rates soared, leading to the baby boomer generation. Throughout the 1950s, dating became more exclusive, and thus the term going steady was born. The 1960s was revolutionary when the first female oral contraceptive was approved by the FDA. You can imagine how that shifted dating in society and women's ability to plan when she would have a baby, if that's what she wanted. Fast forward to the 1970s when rock and roll gave way for the hippie culture. The concept of free love and premarital sex was no longer taboo. In fact, sex was the driving factor to decide whether or not someone would date you long term. No pressure. The hookup culture, as it was later coined, continued into the 1980s, as less people were arranging formal dates and more people were sleeping together. In 1981, the AIDS epidemic first emerged in the US, forever changing the social climate and forcing conversations about sexuality. It wasn't until years later that treatments for the virus were developed and fear began to subside. With the advancement of new technology in the 1990s, you didn't have to date someone in your immediate circle anymore. The World Wide Web introduced you to people in other regions of your city, state, and beyond. In 1998, the movie You've Got Mail was released, and it was the first film of its kind centered around online dating. The idea that you could search widely before selecting a partner became the norm. In the early 2000s, the smartphone revolution took hold, adding a whole new level of courtship and convenience. Looking for love? There's an app for that. In 2012, the height of mobile app use for dating culminated with a staggering 40 million users globally. The convenience of video chat took things to a whole other level. Rather than just a phone call, now you could connect on a deeper level by seeing your boo on camera and picking up on their nonverbal cues. We've come a long way, and our courtship rituals have changed and evolved. Today, we live in an era with less rules and expectations than ever before. We celebrate having freedom of choice in our careers, our relationships, and our sexuality. Seeking arrangement celebrates individualism and encourages open and honest relationships on your terms. Here is to empowered women everywhere who have more say in how they date than ever before. We no longer have to rely on chance or random encounters, and that is something to celebrate.